Revving up the future of two wheels, Kawasaki rolls out a game changer. Meet the Ninja 7 Hybrid, a fusion of raw power and futuristic technology. This isn't a mere leap, it's a quantum jump in the motorcycle world. We're about to unravel the mystery, the mechanics, and the magic behind the world's first mass-produced strong hybrid motorcycle. Here's everything you need to know about Kawasaki's bold stride into tomorrow. Let's talk about something called carbon neutrality. Imagine a scale. On one side, we have all the carbon dioxide. That's a gas that can be bad for our planet, that Kawasaki makes. On the other side, we have things that help take this gas away, like planting trees or using solar energy. Kawasaki's goal is to balance this scale by the year 2035. They want to make sure that they're not adding more bad gas to our air than they're helping to remove. Pretty cool, right? Now, let's shift gears to electrifying motorcycles. You know how some cars don't need gas and run on electricity? Kawasaki wants all their motorcycles to do that too by 2035. This means less pollution and a happier Earth. Speaking of electric, Kawasaki recently introduced two awesome electric bikes, the Ninja E1 and the ZE1. These bikes are super special because they run only on electricity, no gas. This is a big leap towards making riding fun and eco-friendly. And now for the star of the show, the Ninja 7 Hybrid. This motorcycle is like a superhero of bikes. It can use both gasoline and electricity. Think of it having two superpowers. It's the first big-time hybrid motorcycle, and it's paving the way for others to follow. It's all about having a blast on the road while taking care of our planet. Spotted in Turin, Italy, the Ninja 7 Hybrid was seen making its rounds, hinting at an imminent release. This strong hybrid motorcycle, a first of its kind, integrates a 451cc engine with a 9kW traction motor, promising unparalleled performance. The power plant of the Ninja 7 Hybrid is a marvel. The 451cc engine, potentially sharing dimensions with Kawasaki's Eliminator models, combined with the electric motor, delivers a hefty 68.5 horsepower at 10,500 RPM, and a torque of 44 foot-pounds at just 2,800 RPM. This power is nothing short of impressive, echoing the capabilities of Kawasaki's much-loved Ninja 650. Now let's zoom in on one of the most electrifying features of the Ninja 7 Hybrid, the traction motor. This piece of tech is something unheard of in a bike. While 12 horsepower doesn't sound like much, it's the key to the Ninja 7 Hybrid's lightning-fast acceleration. You will soon feel the thrill of zooming off the line with the power that rivals liter-class sports bikes. That's the kind of adrenaline-pumping performance we're talking about here. And that's not even the best part. This traction motor isn't just about speed and power. It's also a champion of fuel efficiency. With this innovative design, Kawasaki has managed to strike an incredible balance. Picture this, you get the acceleration that can go toe-to-toe with the big bikes, while also enjoying the fuel efficiency that you'd expect from a much smaller 250cc motorcycle. It's like having your cake and eating it too. So, how does this all come together? The key is in the seamless integration of the traction motor with the main engine. When you need that extra burst of speed, the electric motor kicks in, giving you that exhilarating boost. And when it's time to cruise, the system dials back, conserving energy and maximizing fuel efficiency. It's a symphony of power and economy, all working in perfect harmony. The Ninja 7 Hybrid's transmission system is super special. It's like having two different gear systems in one bike. When the bike is in ICE mode, which stands for internal combustion engine, that's the part that uses gasoline, it has a manual transmission. This means you get to change the gears yourself, just like you might shift gears on a bicycle. But here's where it gets really exciting. The Ninja 7 also has two more modes, called Eco, Hybrid, and EV. In these modes, the bike takes care of shifting gears for you. It's automatic, kind of like a smart car that knows exactly when to change gears for the best ride. This makes riding super smooth and easy, especially if you're just cruising around town. In Eco, Hybrid mode, the bike uses both electricity and gasoline to get you moving without using too much fuel. It's like having a helping hand to make sure you're riding efficiently. efficiently. And in EV mode, which stands for electric vehicle, the bike runs only on battery power. This is great for short trips and is super quiet and clean for the environment. So why is this so cool? Because it gives you the best of both worlds. You can choose to shift gears manually for a fun, hands-on experience, or you can let the bike do its thing in eco-hybrid and EV modes for an easy breezy ride. The Ninja 7 Hybrid ensures you have an awesome time on the road, no matter how you ride. We all know that a chassis holds everything together. The engine, the wheels, the seat, all the important parts. The Ninja 7 Hybrid has a chassis made of something called a lightweight steel trellis. Picture a strong, light metal frame, kind of like a grid or a network of metal bars. This special design is super important because it needs to hold the regular bike parts and the extra hybrid parts, like the electric motor and battery. Now let's bounce over to the suspension system. The suspension is like the bike's muscles and joints. It helps absorb bumps in the road, so you don't feel every little rock or pothole. Imagine riding over a bumpy road. Without a good suspension, it would be a really shaky and uncomfortable ride. But with a great suspension, like on the Ninja 7 Hybrid, it's smooth sailing. The cool thing about the Ninja 7 Hybrid suspension is that it's similar to what you find on the Ninja 650 and Ninja 400. These are two other awesome Kawasaki bikes. The suspension on these bikes is known for making rides really comfy and stable. That means even on twisty roads or when you're going a bit fast, you feel safe and steady. Why does this matter? Well, when you're riding a motorcycle, especially one as cool as the Ninja 7 Hybrid, you want to feel secure and comfortable. Kawasaki made sure that the frame is strong enough to hold all the high-tech hybrid stuff, and that the suspension keeps your ride smooth and enjoyable, no matter where you're headed. You might be wondering, how much does this awesome Ninja 7 Hybrid cost? Well, here's the thing. Kawasaki hasn't told us the exact price yet, but we can make some smart guesses based on what we know about the bike. The Ninja 7 Hybrid isn't just any ordinary bike. It's packed with some really cool and advanced technology. It has both a gas engine and an electric motor. That's what makes it a hybrid. Plus, it's got all these other high-tech features. So, we think that when Kawasaki does reveal the price, it's probably going to be a lot higher than your regular motorcycles. Now let's switch gears and talk about the battery. The Ninja 7 Hybrid has a special battery that helps power the electric motor. But here's the catch. We don't know yet how big this battery is or how long it takes to charge up. One cool thing we do know is about the bike's fuel economy. Fuel economy is all about how efficiently a bike uses fuel. The Ninja 7 Hybrid is expected to be super fuel efficient, kind of like the smaller 250cc class motorcycles. This means it can go a long way on a little bit of gas, which is great for both your wallet and the environment. We hope this will save you some money on the initial price tag. So there you have it, a sneak peek into the new era of bikes with the Kawasaki Ninja 7 Hybrid. We are all waiting excitedly for more details to be shared, but one thing's for sure, this bike is shaping up to be something really special. Stay tuned for more updates for the latest news on cool bikes and tech stuff. Until then, remember, life is short. Ride more motorcycles.